With time lapses, you can enhance your videos, you can convey the flow of time or simply provide more variety. The GoPro Hero 7 has a time-lapse mode which offers you many possible settings and with which you can achieve interesting and very beautiful results. In this video, I will explain to you how you can optimally set up your GoPro for time-lapses and which settings are available. My name is Werner, I live in the Italian Alps and this channel is about filmmaking and GoPro. Have fun with this video! When you switch to time-lapse mode, you can choose between 4 capture modes. Time warp video, time-lapse photo and night-lapse photo. While the time-lapse modes are mainly intended to fix the camera in a certain place, for example on a small tripod, the time warp video mode is intended for situations in which you move. For example for a bike ride or also for a classic hyperlapse video, in which you move around a building or towards a building or another target. The unique thing about it is that the camera will stabilize the shot as good as possible. I have already made a detailed video about this mode in which I explain all the settings and give tips for optimal results. I link to this video in the video description and will not go into details today. So let's have a look at the other three modes. At the beginning, I would like to briefly explain the basic differences. With time-lapse video, the camera itself automatically creates a video. Several photos are taken at certain intervals and combined to a video. So the camera does the work for you of putting the photos together to create a video file. However, the camera does not save the individual photos, but only the video. The result of your recording is therefore only the final time-lapse video. This not only saves time, but also storage space. Compared to time-lapse photo and night-lapse photo, only a small part of the memory is occupied by the recording. This is an advantage especially if you are on a longer vacation with your GoPro and want to make a time-lapse from time to time, but have only a limited amount of storage available. A disadvantage of this mode is that there are very few settings available. What is the difference between time-lapse photo and night-lapse photo? In both modes, individual photos are taken and stored. So if you want to create a time-lapse video, you have to process the photos with a video editing program. On the other hand, you get all the settings which are available in photo mode, except super photo. The time-lapse photo mode is also intended for situations where you want to take a single photo. You mount, for example, the camera on your helmet, let it shoot photos during your activity in certain intervals, and can then select the best photo. The automatic works therefore the same as with normal photos. Night-lapse photo, on the other hand, is intended for situations with bad lighting conditions. The camera will use a slower shutter speed than with the time-lapse photo. You should therefore always mount it stably to avoid camera shake. Now let's have a look at the settings of the different modes. Time-lapse video. To access the settings of the individual modes, tap on the button at the bottom center. As mentioned before, the time-lapse video settings are very limited. There is no Protean and no RAW mode. You can select the resolution on the left. You have to choose between an aspect ratio of 4:3 and 16:9. A typical video file has an aspect ratio of 16:9. If you set 4:3 but want to obtain the typical aspect ratio of 16:9, you will have to edit and crop the video later on. However, 4:3 also has a decisive advantage. The field of view is extended at the top and bottom. This gives you more flexibility to choose the perfect frame in post. But since you use time-lapse video in most cases because you don't want to do any editing, I would choose an aspect ratio of 16:9 in most cases. Now you can choose between 4K and 1080. Personally, I use 4K for the best possible quality. In the center appears white as field of view. You can't change that in time-lapse video mode. If you want to use linear as field of view, you have to use the time-lapse photo mode. Now we come to a very important setting of your time-lapse video, the time-lapse interval. Here you can set the intervals at which the camera will take the single photos. You have to keep in mind that the photos will be merged into a video file at the end. The video file that is created will contain 30 frames per second. If you select 1 second as the interval, the camera will shoot 1 image per second, which would be 60 images per minute. So if you shoot for 1 minute, 60 pictures will be taken and then merged into a video that will be 2 seconds long. So the larger the interval, the longer your recording has to be to get enough images for a video file. Since you naturally want to make exciting and spectacular shots, you should also know that the correct interval depends mainly on your subject. The slower your subject moves, the longer the interval should be to get enough movement in the final video. In general, I would recommend the following intervals. 1 second if there is a lot of movement, for example with vehicles. 2 seconds for crowds or very fast moving clouds. 5 to 10 seconds for normal cloud movements or also for example for sunrises or sunsets. More than 10 seconds to capture the movements of shadows or even for the night sky with stars. Try to get a feel for what you like yourself. If you have no idea at the beginning and just want to do a time-lapse with clouds, then you can start with 5 or 10 seconds. Time-lapse photo. Now let's have a look at the settings of the time-lapse photo mode. As I said before, you won't get a video file as a result, but a number of single photos. But you have much more options. At the top left, you can set the interval. The same principles apply here as with time-lapse video. If you use this mode to simply take a lot of photos during an activity, that means if you don't plan to create a video from the photos, you could choose an interval of 2 or 5 seconds depending on the activity. In contrast to time-lapse video, you can choose between wide and linear under field of view. Linear is useful if you want to remove the distortion of the fisheye lens. However, this will significantly reduce the field of view. Personally, I like the wide and special look of the fisheye lens of the GoPro, but of course this is a matter of taste. On the right, you can activate the RAW mode. In addition to the individual JPEG files, RAW files are saved. A RAW file contains more information than a JPEG file and therefore gives you more flexibility in post. The RAW files of a GoPro are created in the GPR format and can only be opened and edited without workarounds using Adobe software. That means Lightroom or Camera Raw. This is of course a decisive disadvantage. In addition, the RAW files occupy additional storage space. The RAW mode can only be activated if the interval is set to at least 5 seconds. It is also not compatible with the field of view linear. In addition to RAW mode, in photo mode ProTune is available. I already made a very detailed video about ProTune. I put the link in the video description. Today I would like to go only very briefly into the individual ProTune settings. Exposure value compensation. With exposure value compensation, you can adjust exposure of the images. A positive value makes the image brighter, a negative value makes it darker. If there is a risk that areas of the image that are too bright will burn out, then you should set a slightly negative value, for example minus 0.5 or minus 1. With the white balance, you can adjust the color temperature of the image. For example, to give the image a warmer or cooler tone. Apart from creative decisions, white should always look white. All in all, I am satisfied with the automatic settings of the GoPro. But should you have the impression that the camera changes the white balance during the recording, then you should try to set a fixed value here. Personally, I have never noticed this problem. That's why I mostly use auto here. With the ISO value, you determine how sensitive the camera reacts to light. A higher ISO value therefore leads to a brighter image, which is of course an advantage in low light conditions. Unfortunately, a high ISO value also leads to image noise. That means the image quality decreases as a result. The GoPro is particularly affected by this. For this reason, you should fix the ISO value. That's why I set ISO minimum to 100 and ISO maximum to 400. The sharpness of the GoPro is set to high by default. The image looks very sharp and rich in detail. For photos, this is usually okay. For videos, however, the image appears somewhat unnatural and not cinematic. If you use time-lapse photo to take an individual photo, you should leave the sharpness at high. If you want your time-lapse to be a part of a longer video and you want to create cinematic shots, you can also consider reducing the sharpness by setting it to low or medium. Low usually still needs a slight correction in post. As far as color is concerned, you can choose between GoPro and flat. A flat color profile gives you more flexibility in post. In photography, however, flat color profiles are rather unusual. If you want to edit a photo very heavily, you should use RAW files. If, on the other hand, you want to edit your photos mainly using the video editing program, you can also opt for flat here. For time lapses, I leave this value mostly on GoPro, because I work personally mostly with RAW files. Now let's have a look at the night lapse photo mode. The main difference to the time lapse photo mode is that very long shutter speeds are possible. Also in the automatic mode, the camera will use a longer shutter speed in low light conditions and keep the ISO value low. Therefore, if you use the automatic settings, you should always prefer this mode when the lighting conditions are not good, and this not only at night. This will prevent high ISO values that lead to poor image quality. But you have to use a stable tripod. For possible accessories, I have put some links in the video description. As far as the settings are concerned, you can also set the shutter speed manually here, which is not possible in time-lapse photo mode. This allows you to set the optimal exposure settings yourself. Especially if there is any kind of movement in the shot, this can be important and of course only you can decide how bright the final image really should be. Therefore, it is recommended to take a few test shots before the time-lapse recording. So let's recap. Time warp video. The camera creates an optimally stabilized time-lapse video. This mode is intended for situations where you move the camera while recording. There is already a detailed tutorial on this topic from me, in which I also give tips for optimal results. Time-lapse video. The camera automatically creates a time-lapse video. In comparison to the time warp video mode, the image is not additionally stabilized, but you can set long intervals to accelerate very slow movements like the movements of clouds. Time-lapse photo. In this mode, single photos are taken in certain intervals. If you want to create a time-lapse video, you have to do it yourself, but there are much more settings available, for example ProTune or RAW mode. Compared to time-lapse video, however, you need much more storage space. Night-lapse photo. This mode works very similar to the time-lapse photo mode. The main difference is that a long exposure time is used when taking the photos, which makes sense in low-light conditions. Therefore, you need a stable tripod. The shutter speed can also be set manually. And with that, I would like to say goodbye for today. If you liked the tutorial, give me a like as feedback, subscribe to the channel for more tutorials, and see you next time.